coming to you live from heaven's number one source of news, the Faith News Network.
I'm Cameron Flowers.
And I'm Summer Showers.
Stay with us as we cover God's gift of faith throughout the ages.
Live from the Pearly Gates Plaza, it's your hosts, Cameron Flowers and Summer Showers.
Good morning to all the heavenly hosts. It's another beautiful day here at the Pearly Gates. We are so glad you've joined us for Faith News today. As you know, we shine a big golden spotlight on God's people, those who trust Him and His promises. It's always an honor to sit here next to my co-host, Summer Showers. And may I just say, you have a brilliant new gold spun hairdo.
Thank you, Seedwell. I have to admit, I think of the lineup we have for today, and it is halo-tastic.
With that, let's go to our revolving angel reporters on the ground, Seraphim and Cherubim.
Heavenly morning, Cameron and Summer. We are here in Israel where everyone is abuzz about the subject of our faith news feature this morning.
That's right. What the people are saying here is that Noah's been building a very big boat. And if you know, a very large boat for decades. And if you know the dry weather around here, you know that's pretty weird.
Let's get it straight from his wife, Miss Noah.
Hello.
So, can you tell us a little bit about your wife, Noah?
If you're going to make fun of him, too, I'm not going to.
Oh, no. We are very interested in the construction project going on here.
Oh, in that case, years and years ago, Noah told me that God said he should build a very big boat called...
An ark.
An ark? You've heard of it? And, of course, I told him it's going to be expensive.
I'd imagine so.
You have no idea. So he builds a boat, I think, what do I care? He has a hobby. Then he says he wants to put animals in it. But get this, not just the animals we own, he wants to put two of every animal on the boat.
That's a lot of animals.
Clean up on aisle 5.
Exactly. So guess what I've been doing for the past year? Starting our own zoo. But don't think I'm complaining, mind you. All God's creatures are valuable, and I don't want to be...
Mrs. Noah, I don't mean to interrupt, but do you think we could get your husband to come over?
Sure. I gotta go feed the camels some giraffes anyway. Hey, Noah!
Yes?
Come, meet my new friends. They're not making fun of us. They're actually interested in what God has to say.
Definitely.
Well, you know, I've learned that when God says something, I should obey. He's never given me a reason to doubt him. And if God says it's gonna rain, it's gonna rain.
When God told Noah there was gonna be a flood, it was a little hard to stomach since it's so dry we've never seen mud. I stood by my man, and at least I knew my friends would understand until I told them and heard them say.
It's gonna rain. It's gonna rain. It doesn't make sense. I believe just the same. Makes sense. I believe just the same.
You see, Flo. Yes, as you just saw, it is raining in Noah's neighborhood. Meanwhile, between Elam and Sinai, manna and quail are falling from the sky.
Sorry, Sally, I must have misheard you. Did you say bananas and snails?
Manna and quail. Manna is a type of bread, and quail is a type of bird. Think of it as chicken and biscuits falling from the sky. God is providing for his hungry people. Hallelujah. I am always excited to see what God does next. Of course, in that desert, it is hot, hot, hot. Not a drop of rain there. It's making me thirsty just watching.
Speaking of needing a water break, let's jump to sports. Actually, now the Halos and the Flappers are competing today in the final tournament of the season.
That's right. One thing you want to keep your eyes out for is that leap of faith that both teams will be using. It's the mightiest slam dunk challenge.
Let's go to the Hall of Faith now.
referees are always fair and even.
Flo, I'm here flying over Bethlehem, where there is a camel broken down by the side of the road. It's going to take a while to clear those two speed humps, and over at Samson's village, two enormous pillars have fallen, blocking all access to the main road. If you'll travel back a few centuries with me, looks like the roads around the Red Sea just emptied, so you'll have smooth traveling there. And that's traffic with Wingspan. Back to you, Seaflo.
Thanks for the Eye in the Sky report, Wingspan. Now we take you to Chara and Sarah. Where am I hearing this right? They are walking. I repeat, they are not flying, but walking in a large group around the city of Jericho.
Excuse me, may we talk to you?
My sources tell me that you and your people have been walking in circles around this city for the past 6 days. Can you tell us why?
Sure can. I was near Jericho when an angel appeared before me and said to take off my sandals. I was standing on holy ground.
Oh, right. That was my friend Mike. He told me about that.
What?
Never mind.
Anyways, the angel told me that the Lord delivered Jericho into our hands. We just needed to march one time around the city for 6 days, so that's what we've been doing. But today we are supposed to march around the city 7 times with priests blowing trumpets. Then after the final trumpet blast, the whole army will shout,
and the walls of Jericho will fall to the ground.
Yes, that's what the angel told me. How did you know?
Never mind. That is so exciting, but I noticed those people in the wall towers back there were laughing at you. They didn't seem too concerned. How does that make you feel?
Following God can sometimes feel a little silly, especially when what he asks us to do seems impossible. Each step of faith takes effort, but it gets easier as you walk with him. Which reminds me, word to the wise, if you're going to walk around the city 7 times, you better put on some sensible shoes. Seventh day near Jericho, the day that they'd been waiting for. They marched around the city walls every day the week before.
Tomorrow, let's say daybreak and travel again the word. Tomorrow, let's say time, my Lord, travel over. Keep talking, Joe.
How about the faith in Joshua? It takes faith to believe that just walking in circles would make the walls of an entire city crumble. You know, Summer, faith times looks like foolishness, but it's what pleases God.
Well, Bessie, well. Faith News Today has one last story to report. After that, I'm representing FNN at the Non-Dominational Map Fest on Golden Clouds.
Of course, a real FNN creator. Let's go back to Jared and Sarah.
We are standing here in Hebron about to talk to Abraham and Sarah. Many of you know them as the parents of the nation of Israel.
Here they are now, Abraham, Sarah.
I understand that you are leaving your country and your people to go to a new land. Why?
God told us so.
God said he'd make us into a great nation, which I think is sort of funny, since I don't have any children, and I'm no spring chicken.
I'll never forget it. He said to look up at the heavens and count the stars, and that my descendants would be like that. He said that he would bless me and make me into a great nation. Yes, and all people of earth will be blessed through you. Yes, that's what he said. How did you hear?
It's going around.
That's one pretty big promise. Yep, but God said it, and I believe him.
Do I leave everything I know? Do I simply trust and go?
Promise blessings on this family, that they would outnumber the stars.
Could all people be blessed because of me?
Will you help me trust and believe?
Yeah.
Noah built the ark because he believed in God.
Joshua believed God would deliver Jericho into their hands.
Abraham agreed to go without knowing where he was going.
Faith of any size comes through hearing the promises of God, believing them, and acting on them.